Welcome you all in TLSS video lectures. In this video lecture, we will discuss about the questions of test series, fifth test series for the civil engineering student related to the GATE examinations. So, in this test series, we will also discuss the solutions of the questions. So, total number of questions is 12 in this test and total marks 24. Time allotted is 45 minutes. Is questions carry 2 marks. No negative marking for unattempted and fill up the blanks type questions. So now we will start. So this test series contains the questions of engineering mathematics, general aptitude and environmental engineering. So the first question is for a sample with the ionic composition shown below. The carbonate and non-carbonate concentration in milligram per liter as CuCO3 respectively are dash and dash. So these are the data given for with the help of this you have to find out the carbonate and non-carbonate concentration. Now question number 2 is two samples of water A and B have pH values of 4.4 and 6.4 respectively. So how many times more acidic sample A is than sample B? Okay. So the options are given here. Now in question number 3, it is related to the differential equation. The solution to the ordinary differential equation d2y by dx square plus dy by dx minus 6y equal to 0 is these are the 4 options for this particular questions. Now in question number 4, the question is the variable cost V of a manufacturing a product varies according to the equation V equal to 4q, where q is the quantity produced. The fixed cost F of production of same product reduces with Q according to the equation F equal to 100 by Q. So how many units should be produced to minimize the total cost V plus F? So these are the 4 options for this particular questions. Now we come to the question number 5. The total Kjaerdal nitrogen TKN concentration milligram per liter as N in domestic sewage is the sum of the concentration of. So these are the 4 options for this particular questions. Now we come to the next question. For a given water sample, the ratio between BOD 5 at 20 degree centigrade and the ultimate BOD is 0.51. The value of the reaction rate constant K on base E in per day up to 2 decimal places is dash. So now next question is the crown corrosion in reinforced concrete sewer is caused by H2S, CO2, CH4 and H3. So these are the 4 options. Now question number 8 is a trickling filter is designed to remove set level solids, colloidal solids, dissolved organic matter, none of the above. Next question is, according to the Noise Pollution Regulation and Control Rules 2000 of the Ministry of Environment and Forest, India, the daytime and nighttime noise level limits in ambient air for residential area expressed in dBA L equivalent R dash. These are the 4 options. Now the next question is question number 10. The area bounded by the parabola 2y equal to x square and the line x equal to y minus 4 is equal to these are 4 options. Now question number 11 is, if the arithmetic and geometric means of two numbers are 10, 8 respectively, then one number exceeds the other number by dash. Now question number 12 is the if the probability of A is equal to 1 by 3 and probability of B is 1 by 4 and a probability of A upon B is 1 by 6, then probability of B upon A equal to dash. So this was the question of the test. Now we will discuss this solution also. So question number 1, solution is carbon hardness. So carbon hardness we will calculate in this manner. Carbon hardness is 150 milligram per liter SCOC3, and we know non-carbonate hardness is total hardness minus carbonate hardness. So total hardness is due to the presence of calcium ion and magnesium ion. So in this way the total hardness we calculated as 300 milligram per liter. So non-carbon hardness will be 300 minus 150, so 150 milligram per liter SCOCO3. Now in question number 2, we know the basic formula of pH is minus log hydrogen ion concentration, where the hydrogen ion concentration is in moles per liter. So for sample A, the pH value is given 4.4. So if we use this formula, then we will get the values of the hydrogen ion concentration as 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 5 moles per liter. Now for sample B, the value of the pH concentration is 6.4. So in this way we will find out the value of the hydrogen ion concentration is 3.98 into 10 to the power minus 7 moles per liter. So in this way we will find out the ratio of the hydrogen ion concentration of sample A to the hydrogen ion concentration of sample B is 100. So sample A is 100 times more acidic than sample B. So now we will come to the next question number. So discuss the solution of question number 3. So the differential equation is this: d2y by dx square plus dy by dx minus 6y equal to 0. So in this way complementary function will be the complete solution, because RHS is 0 here. So in this way we will find out the both the roots, and y equal to c1 e to the power 2x or c2 e to the power minus 3x, or we can write in this way also, c1 e to the power minus 3x plus c2 e to the power 2x. So in this way we will find out the answer. Now question number 4, the total cost is c equal to b plus q. So and v is 4q and f is 100 by q. So for minimization of the total cost, we will differentiate with respect to q and equate it with 0, and we will find out the value of q as 5. In question number 5, the answer is c. And the question number 6, we know the BOD5 is L01 minus e to the power minus kt. So and BOD5 by L0 will be 1 minus e to the power minus 5k, and the value of ratio of the BOD5 and ultimate VO is 0.51. so in this way we will find out the value of the k as 0.143. so question number 7, answer is A. Question number 8, answer is C. Question number 9, answer is B. The noise limits area, residential area, the in daytime the limit is 55, in night time the limit is 45 dB decibel. In silence zone, daytime 50 dB, night time 40 dB. Commercial area 65 dB, night time 55 dB. Industrial area, the permissible noise limit is 75 dB in daytime and night time 70 dB. So answer of the question 10 is 18. So in this way we'll solve. We will draw the graph of parabola 2y equal to x square and line y x equal to y minus 4. And using the both the equation, we will find out the points of intersection. So area we can find out in this manner. we'll integrate minus 2 to 4 x plus 4 dx means area under the line and the area under the parabola minus 2 to 4 x square by 2, and we will subtract, we will find out the common portion, common area. Area will be 18, the answer. Now in question number 11, the answer is 12. The arithmetic mean of two numbers a and b is a plus b by 2, and geometric mean of two numbers a and b is under root ab. So according to question, it is given a plus b by 2 is 10 and a plus b will be equal to 20. So under root ab will be 8 and ab is equal to 64, and using the basic formula, a minus b whole square is equal to a plus b whole square minus 4ab, we can find out the values of a minus b is 12, and solving we will get the value of a 16 and b 4. So the difference is 12, so 12 is the answer of this question. Now probability of b upon a is 1 by 8, and probability of a upon b is, we know probability of a intersection b divided by probability of b, and probability of b upon a is probability of b intersection a divided by probability of a. So using these two equation, we will find out the probability of b by a equal to 1 by 8. So thank you for watching this video. For more videos, you can subscribe the TLS channel so that you will be benefited for the preparation of the GATE as well as engineering service examination related to civil engineering. Thank you.